No one can help you. You're my girl now. And I'm horny!
You are probably wondering how we got here. Oh no, that's not me. Very funny. No, how we got into this drive-thru, since the person in front of me appears to have ordered everything on the menu. You know, I guess we could talk about a movie to pass the time. Let's just jump into it. I mean, right off the bat, I can't even get through the opening credits without doing me a concern. I mean, just take a look. Did you catch that? This time I'll make it a little easier for you. Excuse me. Blackface? In 2007? Really? Why though? I mean, come, what do you have? Like, why would you, why? And then I think the funniest thing as we go on is I can't even tell what instance of blackface they're referring to. I think I do. I think it's very obvious, but then if you have to think about what constitute as blackface in your movie, I think you're doing something wrong. I mean, I don't mean to spoil the experience, but there's a little bit of a celebrity cameo. So let's be on the watch and see who we can find. There he is. Nuka Zeus in the house.
I'd be like, hi, I'm black. Nice to meet you.
Where we going, player?
Motherfucking hella burger, yo. Gonna get a double chili cheese all up in here, nigga.
Oh my god. Like double chili cheese.
Yeah.
This is a minute in and I already feel like I'm having an aneurysm. Motherfucking hella burger, yo. I'm gonna need that demonetization jar out for this video, young skillet. So many questions. First, hella burger? The name of your burger joint is Hella Burger. That's lit, fam. That's hella sick, dude. Yeah, we don't need to talk about that. Awkward. That line of dialogue, also awkward. That pan shot to the sunroof for no reason, awkward. One second, let me just... yeah, sounds about right. One set.
Hella burger.
These, excrements of the gene pool place their order to Horny the Clown. Yep. Horny the Clown. This is a hard flick for me to talk about because they are constantly just dropping the dumbest lines of dialogue, and it renders me speechless. These moments are just equal parts hilarious and cringe. It is somehow both really funny and just really cringy and awkward. Like, how is one supposed to comment on this interaction?
Yo, we don't want no motherfucking cheesy dicks, clown boy.
Can I fuck your whore, Wigger?
I want a milkshake. Ooh. Chocolate.
Yo, you busting out your Tommies as it is, booty quake.
You want a dick?
You want fries with that?
Yeah. There's the poke shit in the woods.
These dudes aren't happy with Horny clowning on them, so they go in to, I guess, murder him? But everyone's gangster until...
First things first, I'm the realist.
But because this is the beginning, arguably this movie's best characters are gone too soon.
Sorry, homie, that just ain't gonna happen.
Sad but true, but I actually think the clown costume is intimidating and does stand out. I think it's a neat design. So it's definitely a positive this movie has going for it. So good job, Mr. Burger. The generic final girl protagonist of this movie is Mackenzie, and the film wants you to know two things about her. One, got a nice ass. Two, hasn't turned 18 yet. Probably should have led with that second one. But hey, don't look at me. Film's words, not mine.
Oops, go to war. And you won't go to jail.
Have you seen your ass? How's a young hormone junkie like me supposed to be patient?
I'm sorry, what?
How's a young hormone junkie like me supposed to be patient?
Okay, that's what I thought. Carry on. Here's where we get introduced to the most unexpected part of my murderous clown flick. Muddled political commentary. The slasher has always kind of been conservative in nature. There's a reason why the teens who do social taboos and drug, sex, and rock and roll are the ones being murdered, while the wholesome virgin girl is the one who survives. But here, they make the main girl super annoying and like a punk, is like doesn't have respect for anyone. She wants to have sex. She does drugs. Is she the moral high ground of this film? But I was gonna say that we don't really know anyone else. But I guess they do kind of suck from what little bits we do get to see of them. But I mean, having a demonic serial murderer clown endorsing your political views so openly is certainly strange. I don't know what it's trying to tell me. I really... All I know is it's very brown nose. It's very on the nose.
What up, man?
Dude, that party's still banging?
Nah, 5-0 just rolled up. Shit is dead as Nixon.
But I already know you're gonna abandon me when we graduate. And I'll die. Fat. Alone. And Republican. In Orange County, which is pretty much worse than going to hell.
They say, if you're 20 and you're not a liberal, you don't got a heart.
And if you're not Republican when you're 50, you got no money.
Write in one of your famous left-wing, radical, anti-establishment articles for the paper, are you?
And he offed himself, textbook murder-suicide scenario.
That's the thing about this movie, there's nothing beyond the surface, but it's very aware of that. There's no allegory, there's no theme, nothing but clowning around. But let's get into the mystery. Who is this 7-foot-tall psycho clown? Let's see if you can figure it out.
Lenny, where did you find this?
You don't want to know.
My son.
Okay. Is he still being horny? Playing horny?
Archie? No. He hasn't done that since he was a kid. He's, passed away now.
Chad.
I couldn't help it. You're just too sexy.
Yeah, right. I'll start fretting.
Roll it up, light it, let me catch a red eye. Go chase my money on this fucking red eye. Testing Caliban is a suicide. It's a suicide.
And the true culprit is... It was the clown. The reason why the plot is so shallow is because it's just a reskin of Nightmare on Elm Street, to the point where it's even in the Amazon review tags. The script for this movie is just so bad. It's like all the work went into the puns and the quips, and none of them are actually particularly clever.
Oh, look! Tina McCandless and Chad Baldwin.
You mean Abercrombie and Bitch.
Wait a minute. Is that Neil Patrick Harris's nephew?
God, this place is lame tonight. Probably explains why you losers are working here.
Are you supposed to be scary, fish face?
Oh, not as scary as the dockers you have halfway up your ass, Chad.
How'd you like my foot all the way up your ass?
I'm sure what you meant to say was dick.
So, do you and your slut pop want to buy, like, a ticket or what?
Sweet costume, Mac. I was beginning to suspect you were a lesbo. Now I'm sure.
Well, as long as the gene pool is filled with bottom feeders like you, I have to keep my options open.
Ew, gross! What a fucking bitch!
Duty calls!
I phrased as a whodunit, but it really isn't, because none of those characters would fit in the 7-foot-tall clown costume. And there's all this paranormal shit that keeps happening throughout. It would make no sense for any other character to be, like, doing this.
N1KL
Bathroom. Who are you?
I do think it's funny how the angle of the mom being linked to the murders happens abruptly. Like, this is how they introduced the idea of that.
Mackenzie, will you please talk to me? Are you ever planning to tell the police that the parents of all the victims are your old buddies?
What's that got to do with anything?
You're joking, right? Mother, it's a very definite pattern. That's what it's got to do with everything.
It's more like an awful coincidence, Mackenzie.
There's no research or, like, a thinking scene. Mackenzie just straight up just knew that it couldn't be just, you know, a coincidence. That, you know, in this small town, all the murdered kids' parents knew each other. Despite, you know, it being kind of like a small town. I feel like this review is greatly unfocused and sporadic. Kind of like the film, so I can surprise you with all the nonsense of this film like this.
Double your pleasure. Get two orders of my XXX hella hot wings for the price of one. Now that's a money trap.
Part of me just finds this XXX gimmick highly inappropriate and bizarre for a fast food joint, but at the same time, Carl's Jr. used to film softcore porn and call it an ad, so anything's possible.
Meets Max. It's a win.
See?
Face us.
It just makes me feel better.
I just thought the, kind of the joke of this scene is that the burger looks gross beyond belief, but like, have you seen what Arby's considers food? Well, there's a celebrity can. It's Kamala Harris! She's right there!
We did it! We did it, Joe!
Oh, that's the celebrity cameo. Hayley Williams from Paramore. No, but all jokes aside, it's Morgan Spurlock from Super Size Me, because of course.
Can't you read the sign?
Sweet!
Hey! You don't want to dance with me, Shirley. Listen, I got your number, cucumber. That's it. I'm calling the authorities. You
better control your friends or they're going to end up in the who's gal.
The what?
Just get them out of the play space, okay?
Whatever. Where's your shitter?
Language. The ladies' room is around the corner.
Is this the blackface in this movie? Now, I want to, you know, give you the context that he is doing sort of a military, sort of like Heart of Darkness kind of thing. That, you know, I don't think this was blackface. But the fact that I have to ponder what instance of blackface the movie wants to warn me about is a really concerning question. Eventually, Horny kills pretty much everyone except for our protagonist. And I guess this guy, but he gives him extreme dry eye.
I have special eyes.
Look with your special eyes.
My brand.
So he's gonna miss the party. And I mean, come on, dude. Really? Even the girl who had her head explode in a microwave somehow glued it back together and came to this party. Then mom comes to save the day and does pretty much nothing. But, you know, it buys Mackenzie enough time so she can, you know, get some alcohol in her mouth so she can spit it from point blank range and somehow catch him on fire. In a way, without burning herself in the process. Which is impressive given that she was drenched in gasoline. I mean, checks out. With evil defeated, the only scary thing now is that this movie tried to have a sequel. At least, I mean, how could you fuck up the credits? Shout out to the line producer! I just want to take a second to also think that it's really weird that it's the line producer that gets this whole gap in the credits, considering that, you know, a regular producer that handles like the pre-production and the post-production as well as the physical production is, you know, considered a more prestigious position because it's considered above the line, while a line producer is still considered below the line. Very, very odd, especially because there's only associate producers, so I don't know why they wouldn't want the full credit. Odd. Arnie is a cool character, so thank you, Jeff Bridges. Also, associate producer Zach Tobacco. I'm not surprised at this point. This movie is incredibly stupid, but don't get me wrong, it's a fun enough time that, you know, I probably could have used being under the influence of something. Not that I endorse that, but I mean, this movie's kind of asking for it. This film isn't irredeemable. I didn't really show it, but I think the practical effects work and some of the kills here are really gnarly and cool. And it was way better than I expected. And it's a real shame that most of them are done with just the meat cleaver, because I can't help but feel like it looks like it came from the Spirit Halloween store. It's like, come on, really? Like, you put all this work, but like the weapon itself just looks so cheap and like dumb that like it kind of, you know, takes away from it. The editing makes some really odd choices, especially with Horny the Clown moving at supersonic speeds from time to time. Very in your face. The last complaint I guess I have is just the music. It's atrocious and I hate it. It's so aggressive and overbearing. Like, can it even get copyrighted? Like, can anyone identify what these loud noises are?
Why are you running? Why are you running?
Maybe it's just not my type of music and I can accept that. But yeah, it's not good. It doesn't help the scene. It's just very distracting and loud. In the end, surprisingly, this movie is short and silly enough to be considered a decent watch, but it's far from a good movie with just aggressively amateur filmmaking and writing. What else is there to say? But thank you for joining me on this ride, and hopefully I will see you next time here at the movies, or maybe the sequel. Like, oh my god. Double chili cheese.
Yo, we don't want no motherfucking cheesy dicks, clown boy.
Yeah. Does the Pope shit in the woods, my home slice? My voice shizzle?
Have you seen your ass? How's a young hormone junkie like me supposed to be patient?
Couldn't help it, you're just too darn sexy.
Food kills, fucker.